recently a subject of focus in a recent White House visit with the President of the United States, in which our Fraternal Order of Police was able to highlight the local broken system of catch-and-release criminal justice in Indianapolis.
Desai Smith is the type of offender Rick Snyder was talking about. In 2018, when she was still 17 years old, Smith led a crew on the west side that was committing robberies while she was supposed to be on probation and home detention for another armed robbery conviction. Last October, Smith received a 9-year prison sentence for armed robbery, but a month before that, she was arrested for battery, strangulation, and criminal confinement charges stemming from an incident while she was out on bond and awaiting trial. Judges rely on a pretrial risk assessment matrix system to determine who should be released and who should stay in jail pending trial. Snyder complains judges should have the power to overrule the matrix and use their judicial common sense.
We know that we have a system that takes into account histories and renders a recommendation. That's great, but it should be a human being judge that's reviewing that and finalizing that decision.
The matrix was established to remove the guesswork for judges and, in theory, reduce jail overcrowding by low-risk offenders, instead sending them to community correction to be fitted for a GPS monitor to await trial sitting at home.
And if we have a series of incidents where people are violating, you know, their bail conditions, I mean, I think that's serious from the standpoint of impacting crime that's going on in the community. Guys that are cutting off their pre-trial release bracelets so that they can go out and commit other crimes.
Snyder's also calling for lawmakers to establish a study of criminal justice reform outcomes and a database to track violent crime participants to monitor future victims and suspects. Russ McQuaid, CBS 4 News.
And county sheriffs across Indiana are also calling on lawmakers to boost reimbursement funding for local jails that house low-level state inmates.
Now it's 6. Welcome up.